All our dear associate partners, warm welcome to Join in Campus. Here we are going to present our training session related to our integration and the automation that we have placed between your agent panel, that is your own account, and the CRM system, which we have prepared for seamless application catering. So here I am going to present you some information that how this functionality will work, that will help you to submit your application through your own portal. So let's start. Before proceeding for the further process, here I would like to show you some importance of this tool so that you can correlate with it. Whatever the functionality we have started now, so that is very beneficial at both the ends. This will give you access for 100% application of your agent panel. That means whatsoever student file you are sending to us now, you can 100% send those files through this agent panel. This will create a non-dependency wherein you are no more dependent to us on emails. This is a very user-friendly automation that we have placed, and that is very less time consuming. So that will lead to a less time for administration work, and you can do a more better productive work at your level. So here I'm starting the session. So let's connect it. So to use this functionality, first of all, you have to go onto your own agent panel. So for that, there are two ways. You are having already a link of your agent panel. However, if you are not having that, you can simply log in into Join in Campus website. That is www.joinincampus.com. Here you will get a button for agent login. Whenever you just click on this button, you will be redirected on agent panel, which is specifically defined for you as per a B2B business model. So here the username and password are already assigned to you. So you need to just log in with your username and password. Here I'm logging, and this kind of screen will open. So I'm not going through with the entire stuff right now. We are just going one by one. And I would like to inform you all that this is just a first automation that we have placed. We are coming up with many more automations that will, you know, make your experience more better with Join in Campus. So here I'm going to present only one section for now, which is add a student. You will get that button here and here as well. So first of all, you need to click on add student button to submit your student application. So now from now onwards, we will be receiving and accepting all the application that would be coming from this particular functionality. No more application from email or any other mode. Please take a note of it. You have to click on add student here. First of all, you need, there are the first section is deal source. So whatsoever application that are self-sourced by you, you need to just simply select self. The partnership wala part, your respective PRMs would let you know that in which case you need to select partnership. Associate counselor. So for each of you, there are the respective partner relationship managers assigned. So accordingly, you can select your respective partner. So that application would directly go to them account. So here I'm selecting this one. Here you need to place your respective student name for which you are going to submit that file. So I'm just putting the name here. Suppose. And I'm writing test because I'm just showing one or testing that how this particularly functionality would work. You need to simply select the gender over here, the student date of birth. You can simply take it from here, whatsoever is applicable. I'm just taking randomly anyone, the email ID, student email ID. So that please make sure all the information that you people are putting in, that should be correct at one time because this will be considered as a final information and that would be not editable after you will submit it. I will show you how. You need to put any number over here, that means not any student number, student's Skype ID, a student country. So suppose I'm saying it is India, the state from which state a student belongs is simply you need to just drop in down selections, a student city. Suppose I'm saying it is Delhi. Here you need to just click on to the save and continue. This is the student personal information section. So all the information that is mentioned by you is the student's personal information. We will just go on to the next. We will just save and continue it, and then you would be coming up with the education information wala section, wherein you need to just place all the academic information of the student. So this is the education history, what all the student has done in past and what is going to be in future, that what is the student is looking forward. So here, highest level of education, suppose he has cleared his bachelor degree, exam appeared. So whatsoever, if student has appeared for any exam, you can simply select from here exam score. You need to write it down. Suppose I'm writing here 6.6. If the student is having any work experience, you need to simply select the number of years of experience. If not, then you can simply place it zero. Intake, for which intake a student wants to go abroad, so that you need to select over here the year. Suppose I am saying that is for 2022. Here you need to select the country, in which country student wants to go, the school and the course. All the selection you will be getting here itself, you need to just simply drop down selection. Here one more thing is that as per the joining campus rule, a student can maximum apply into three schools or for three different courses. So in case there are the multiple selection for a particular student, you can always place or click add here. That will give you the accessibility to select the another country or the another option. So suppose I am saying again student wants to go in France, the country is same, however he or she wants to apply into the another school as per the admission he or she would receive and the another one. So maximum three selection you can place. So here, if you want to remove all this, suppose the second and the third selection, you can simply click over here and you can remove. Visa refusal before. So if in case any visa refusal student has gone through in the past, simply if yes, then you need to simply select yes, and then you need to select the country for which country the visa was refused, in which month and in which year. If not, you can simply select no and go ahead, save and continue. Here is the section wherein you need to just submit all the mandatory documents over here. So here are the specification given to the mandatory document. This star is showing the mandatory documents, and the non-star, likewise this, these are the optional. However, you need to just place all the documents for the seamless application so that the application directly can be sent to school. So here, suppose we select any of the documents. I'm just doing a sample. This is how you need to select documents. I'm just placing one document over here just to give you the brief idea how this functionality would work. However, you need to submit all the specific documents just to check whether you are selecting the same document or the correct document as per the header that is given here. Suppose if you are uploading the passport first page, make sure that would passport first page should be uploaded. So this is how you need to just upload your documents. So while you are preparing any application or you are submitting, going to submit any application, please make your documents handy. See, this is how I just put in. I am just lefting these three out just to give you an idea that if that is non-mandatory, the portal will accept your application. And if the documents are mandatory, you have to specifically upload those documents, otherwise your application would not be stored. And this is how, if somewhere you find that instead of resume you have posted some another document, so you can simply remove from here and you can re-upload. Likewise this. And here we need to just save and submit. So this will take us some time because all your documents would be and all the application details, whatever we have mentioned or uploaded here, that would be scattered as in file creation into the system server, so that we can make sure and secure your information. Please take a note that all the information that you are submitting over here, that is well secured. So this will take some time. Maximum time to upload and create a system created file for this, that is 1 minute to 2 minutes. So this is how it will take. It will give you a pop-up. Let's wait for that. And how this will work further, I'll go through it. The main part is that you will get a reference ID, which we will create a deal ID, that will be your unique reference ID for all this functionality. So by that reference, you will be getting all the information available on this portal itself. Or otherwise, if you are having any such query, you can connect to your PRM with reference of that particularly deal ID. That will help to get your information more effectively and more speed. Yes. So when all your documents will be uploaded, and you will click on save and submit button, this is the window you will be getting. So here I'm just reading it down. Are you sure you will not be able to change this data after submit? So please check once again. This is indicating that whatever the information you have placed over here, are you double sure that this information is perfectly fine? And if you want to change that, you can have a chance only once. Because after getting this data into the system, it will not give you a chance to change that data. So please make sure whatever the data you have placed, that should be 100% accurate. Whenever you just click on this yes send it button, your application would be submitted with us. And also it will give you a deal ID for which I am talking about. See, this kind of wizard will open and you will get to know that what all information has been uploaded. So here you can see the document resume has been uploaded, the statement purpose. So what all documents you have uploaded, this will give you information that all the details are successfully uploaded, along with the deal ID for which I was talking about. And here you will get an SMS, deal has been created successfully. So whenever any information or any student file is placed under this functionality or function, it is mandated to come over a deal ID. If you are getting that deal ID, it is indicating that your file is submitted successfully and reached out to your respective PRM. If you have not received any deal ID, means the file is not reached to your respective PRM. That is a simple logic about it. When I'm clicking OK here, this is how you will see the records on the same section. If you click over here, add a student, see, this is how this view will look. So what all applications you have sent to us till the time, you will get all the details here. See, this is the deal ID. If you want to search anything from deal ID, from student name, from student mobile number, from student email ID, you can simply place the data here and you can search it out. Likewise, I'm doing from student name. We have put a deal Himali test here. I'm searching it out. See, this is the result. This is how this functionality would work. And if you click on this cross button, all the submitted details you will be able to see here.
Here you will get the deal ID, a student name, student mobile number, student email ID for which intake student has applied, current deal stage. I'm coming over on this section in detail afterwards. And this is the student city on which date this application is being submitted. You will be able to see here. Whenever you will be clicking on this particularly blue button, that means the student name, you will be able to see the internal view. So this is how we have placed the information. See all the information that you have entered, you will able to see here, but you will not able to change it because that is being freezed. Same way, education information and the documents, you can upload those document and check whatever the documents you have been submitted. And here comes the most effective and the automation part that we have come across, face details. Whenever your deal will be created along with the deal ID, these two functions or section will open. But before proceeding that, let me give you a one detailed brief also. See, here the deal ID is not there. Here it is showing zero, for which I was just talked about. It indicates that deal is not yet received in your PRM's account. So whenever you are just seeing zero here, please always recheck all the data and click on this part. Recheck all your data and then again place recheck all again data and please make sure you just click on this button, save and submit. And are you sure? If that is all done, then you will get the deal number over here, right? Again, we are going back into the section for which I was talking about. Yes, here you will get all the fees detail, whatever the fees has been paid or need to paid along with the currency. This all details would be submitted by your respective PRM as in when your application would get processed. So you will get to know the actual idea about where your application is at this time. So current, whatever is happening with your application, you can always get to know from here. So here are the fees detail information and here is the application status. So we have categorized all the application life cycle into 22 stages, whether it is a successful or it is unsuccessful. So this is how we have give the categorization over here. This green button is showing that current application status. So wherever your current application would be in whatsoever place, you will get this green tick over there. Application processed. So whenever you will just get this blue tick, that means the application has passed all these stages and currently that is fall into this particular stages. Not applicable means suppose your file is, that means your student is successfully received admission, then his there are no chances to admission rejection. So this stage would be not applicable here. So you will get this gray button over here. If you have applied in three schools, different schools, different courses, different countries, so whatsoever the final country, school and course in which a student has received the application, admission and paid the fees, that would be reflected here. So you can get the real-time picture and idea about your application. So this is how this functionality is being prepared and I have given you a detailed brief about it. If still you are having any such queries, you can always reach out to your respective PRMs. But please make sure that from now onward, whatever the files you are going to submit, please submit from here. And if you are getting any such queries and concerns, please reach out to your respective PRM. We will sort it out as soon as possible. You will also get this video recorded so that you can refer this for your reference purposes. And you can use this functionality for the more accessible environment from joining campus. So this is from my end. Thank you so much for this session. And let's grow together as per our motto. And we are coming up with many more automations. So let's keep waiting for that. We'll just keep you posted. Thank you so very much.